All right, what's going on, everybody? I am nasty sweaty. You can tell, just got done washing this Toyota RAV4 behind me. We're just gonna do a walk around on it. This is for a guy that owns a car dealership close to me. So basically, what they get done is just your interior, degrease the jams, engine bay, kind of make it showroom ready on this one. We're just gonna do inspection on it, see the condition of it before, and then we'll do one after as well. Alright, ignore the garage mess. It's kind of crazy in here. I would open the doors, let some airflow in, but I've been getting eaten alive by mosquitoes. And they like to drink my blood. Anyways, did a rinseless wash on it. Got the tires cleaned up on it and everything. It's still rocking some snow tires in June, so I'm ready to go for all terrain on it. Paint is not in the best shape. It's been repainted. There's overspray all over everything. Does look like it's rocking some new Wish lights. Looks like it has a little bit of fade going on there. Some damage there in the front as well. Lots of scrapes here in the paint. Probably not gonna do anything else with the inside besides just wipe it down really good. I honestly don't wanna use any of my microfibers on it. I'll show you kind of what's going on with the roof and the reason why. See the exterior here, you see the paint's all faded right there. Chipping right there as well on it. Bumper's loose, it's been repainted on it as well. And then if we look on the roof, you can actually see it's just totally peeled up and everything. It was stuck together with Bondo. So yeah, I don't wanna get my microfibers on that and get paint chips stuck in them. Everything like that. What's super cool about this RAV4, and something I bet you didn't know, is in the early 2000s when they came out with this model year, they actually equipped them with a third row. Let me show you that here. First off, I love this tailgate, and then it opens up like this. I think that's how all tailgates should be. But yeah, you get a little tiny baby third row. Just don't have legs if you're sitting in the back, but it just folds down nice, neat in there. But yeah, these are super cool. And I think they only did them certain places or whatnot. You especially had a special order them, but yeah, you can get them with a third row. So kind of neat, especially in such a small SUV. The interior, actually the plastics look like they've been cleaned up before. My guess, this is probably on another dealer's lot previously. There are some things that we're going to take care of, just all the nooks and crevices right there. You can see there's garbage in there on the floor and whatnot. Going to get the carpet cleaned up a little bit more as well on it. Let's see there, we're going to clean up those floor mats a little bit more. This was smoked in at one point, big hole right in there. Just kind of some dirt and dust, like nothing too crazy, but it's still got, you know, marks on the ceilings and whatnot, and that's kind of what we're going after cleaning today. Squeeze by here. You see my huge, giant mess I got going on. Just a little bit more messing right there. The seats, there's some. Yeah, there's some as well. Looks like I got some pieces in there. So yeah, I'll have to keep track of all the little broken pieces and just put them into a bag or something like that so we don't lose them in case they need them. This format's probably the worst one. I don't know what happened. It looks like it almost got burnt right there on the side on it, but just some slight staining going on the seats and everything like that. Just a little bit of thinking about it. Checking there. Looks like it got some. So nothing too major, but we're gonna get cleaned up and looking fancy. All right, here she is, all done. Looking nice and ready for the lot. Tire shined up. Got that back tire cleaned up. Looking good. It sucks this paint's in such a horrible state, but it is what it is, I guess. Let's go take a look on the inside here. I wish it would have come out better, but you kind of got to know when to say stop on it. This carpet just had a lot of dirt in it, and it was really frustrating to deal with, but it definitely looks a ton better than it did. You can still see there's like some staining and stuff. It was just absolutely like almost impossible to get out. That's what happens with older vehicles, especially if they haven't really been detailed too much, is there's just staining that's stuck in there. Like on these seat belts, there's some staining right in there. And that was after, so I think I worked about 3 hours just on the fabrics alone. And that was using a steam cleaner, which shoots out about 200 degrees. Cleaning it, these back seats actually came out pretty nice. But that shoots out about 200 degrees. And using my carpet cleaner as well. Sorry, I'm trying to put the seat back one-handed. Actually, yeah, sometimes they don't come out perfect, but you know, sometimes perfection is what we're going for. We're just looking for better. And this definitely came out a lot better. You can see it down there too. Makes it better. But yeah, we'll make a super cool, nice little rig for somebody to get their family around in and everything. Yeah, this actually came out pretty nice, which I was pretty happy about. That was pretty nasty before. But yeah, that's what a detail looks like on a RAV4. Total altogether, it probably took between 3 to 5 hours on this one. And this was pretty dirty. Like I said, most of it was actually spent just doing on the fabrics. Most of my interior details range between 4 to 6 hours. That does include an exterior wash on the outside, as you can see, cleaning up the tires, addressing the exterior and everything like that as well. But yeah, pretty happy with how this came out, and hopefully we'll get some more here soon.
Even when you feel low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go. Even when there's no hope, you can still go. I never answer to no.